an mRNA twist to the HIV vaccine problem. For decades, researchers have tried to craft a successful vaccine for HIV. mRNA vaccines may offer the answer. In 1987, the National Institutes of Health, NIH, began its first ever clinical trial of a vaccine against human immunodeficiency virus, HIV-1. While that particular vaccine candidate showed no serious safety concerns in the trial participants, it eventually failed, as did most other HIV vaccine candidates that cropped up within the next 2 decades. This trend has unfortunately persisted. Earlier this year, Janssen Pharmaceuticals ended a late-stage clinical trial of its HIV vaccine candidate because it was ineffective, marking the end of the vaccine furthest along in the clinical trial pipeline, too. With the advent of mRNA vaccines, scientists hope that this narrative of vaccine failure may be changing. Scientists at multiple universities, the NIH, and Moderna are developing several mRNA-based HIV vaccine candidates that they hope will prove effective in preventing HIV infection. While these candidates are all currently in early-stage clinical trials, their existence marks a shift in vaccine development after the COVID-19 pandemic. A tricky, genetically diverse virus, HIV is an extraordinarily tricky virus. They say that there's as much genetic diversity of HIV within a chronically infected individual as there is genetic diversity of influenza in the entire world, said Aaron Sees, a biologist at the Fred Hutchinson Cancer Center. Because of this genetic diversity, finding a shared viral component that a single vaccine can target is difficult. Adding on to the genetic diversity, HIV also infects critical cells of the immune system, CD4 helper T cells. CD4 cells are essential for developing a protective immune response against infections, said Brett Leave, who directs the Infection Disease Clinical Development Group at Moderna. So, the virus is ingenious in that it infects the very target that is essential for prevention. These two factors, among others, create the perfect storm for HIV to be sneakily adept at infecting human cells. Once the virus enters the body, it spreads via the lymph nodes, exponentially replicating across the body's immune cells. 3. After approximately a month, a set point occurs where viral replication reaches a steady rate. 3. If untreated, HIV causes massive loss of those important CD4 helper T cells, chronic inflammation, and over the course of several years, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, AIDS. 3. Currently, therapies for HIV include strong cocktails of antiviral drugs that stop the virus from replicating once it has infected the body. Individuals can also take pre-exposure prophylaxis, PrEP, regularly, which protects the body from being infected by the virus. 4. The goal of the HIV vaccine, then, would be to protect everyone against HIV in one fell swoop. Making new vaccines, from prior vaccine trials, the scientists realized that a certain type of antibody was immensely useful in the body's fight against HIV. Known as broadly neutralizing antibodies, BNABs, these antibodies neutralize many different strains of HIV. Some BNABs can bind to a specific site on the virus's spiky protein envelope called the CD4 binding site. Because HIV needs the CD4 binding site to enter a cell, that site is well conserved between different variants. If we can find an antibody that is going to attack the CD4 binding site of HIV, then we can block the infection, Sees explained. A team at the Scripps Institute of Research discovered that by arranging many copies of an HIV glycoprotein critical for viral cell entry on the surface of a nanoparticle, they could induce the production of these BNABs. 5. By injecting the vaccine into human participants in a phase 1 clinical trial, the researchers introduced the participants' naive B-cell precursors to this protein-conjugated nanoparticle, called the EOD-GT860-MER immunogen, 6. As those B-cells matured, they spawned more antibody-producing cells, leading to a vast array of immune cells producing BNABs, 6. This process is known as germline targeting. Lamar Fleming, a biologist at the Fred Hutchinson Cancer Center, characterized this as a sort of polishing and fine-tuning of the antibodies that are being generated to maximize the amount of BNABs produced. These BNABs are critical to mounting an effective immune response against HIV. We found out that a single bNAb is probably not going to provide enough protection, Fleming said. We're probably going to have to come up with a way to elicit multiple bNAbs. When scientists tested the EOD-GT860 MER immunogen as a protein-based vaccine in a Phase 1 clinical trial, they found that bNAb precursors were indeed generated in almost all vaccine recipients, 6. There were no adverse effects, indicating that the vaccine was relatively safe. The next steps, said Leave, are to transform the EOD-GT860 MER immunogen into an mRNA vaccine. What we're doing is trying to show that with an mRNA version of the immunogen, we can generate the same results, or perhaps even better than what we saw in the initial study. Leave said. This Phase 1 clinical trial is ongoing, 7. Besides the EOD-GT860 MER mRNA vaccine candidate, three other mRNA HIV vaccine candidates developed by the same teams at Scripps Research Institute and Moderna are also racing through a Phase 1 clinical trial sponsored by the NIH. These candidates, like EOD-GT860 MER, also generate pieces of the HIV spike protein critical for entry into cells, but are genetically modified, 8. We're testing a version that is secreted, a version that is membrane-bound, and one that has a genetic deletion where the binding site to CD4 is, said Leave. The team hopes that through the clinical trial, they will figure out which of these candidates can produce the most potent bNAb response and if these bNAbs can successfully neutralize different strains of HIV in the laboratory. Moving to mRNA, while these four vaccine candidates present slightly different versions of HIV envelope proteins, they are all mRNA-based. According to Leave, some of the advantages to mRNA vaccines are that they are easily customizable and faster to produce than protein-based vaccines. With an mRNA-based vaccine, researchers only need the genetic sequence. Like we demonstrated in the response to COVID-19, we can go from sequence to a safe product for use in humans in a matter of months, he said. Researchers can synthesize and test different mRNA vaccine candidates and rapidly iterate and refine our ideas, Leave added. The speed by which researchers develop these vaccines means sifting through massive amounts of biological material and long days in the laboratory. Sees recalled the controlled chaos required to process and understand all of the immunological data generated from the clinical trial. We had 17 different thermocyclers going all at once, just trying to get everything running and finished. He said. That sense of accomplishment you feel after everything's finished, that was a good memory. The scientists hope that at least one of the candidates can prove effective in preventing HIV, although many more studies and clinical trials are needed. Until then, they will keep pushing forward, both in developing more vaccine candidates and understanding how the virus works.